瞬間にはお前の世界は終わってる。
かつて戦闘アニメーションを描くことは選ばれし者だけの領域だった。情熱と汗、果てなき修練。
Hey everyone, it's Naegiko. I hope you're well. Today, I'm excited to share something that honestly feels like a step forward in AI anime generation. Midjourney has released its own video model. Yep, the same team behind those artistic AI images is now stepping into the world of motion. And this model is something you really need to get to know. So, if you're into AI anime, storytelling, or you're just curious about what's possible now, you're in the right place. With Midjourney V1, we finally get something that many other tools were still struggling with. It combines both dynamism and a distinctive visual quality which has been difficult to blend until now. This model is also a Swiss Army knife that handles dynamism, depth, lighting effects, special effects, camera movements, facial expressions, and physics all at once. Alright, so in this video, we're going to take a deep dive into this new model. We'll look at what makes it so innovative, but also talk honestly about its limitations. I'll also take the opportunity to compare it with some of the other top models out there, just to give you a quick overview of the best tools currently available for creating AI-generated anime. And stick around till the end, I'll also be sharing some info about upcoming tutorials on the channel that I think you're really going to enjoy. So, to generate your videos, you have two main options. The first is to upload images directly from your computer. And the second, which is what we'll be doing here, is to use images you've already generated with Midjourney. So in this case, I'm just going to click on an image I've already created. And down here in the bottom right menu, you'll see a few different options. If I click this one, it's going to generate a video with high motion, meaning the animation will be more dynamic and energetic. This other option will create a video that's much more subtle and less dynamic. Let's try both so we can compare the results. And there we go, the videos are now being generated. Alright, so here's what we get. This is the result with Motion High. As you can see, Motion High gives us dynamic camera movements and more action in the character's animation. You can really feel the energy. There's motion in the camera, motion in the character, it's fluid, it's alive. Now, compare that with Motion Low. As you'll notice right away, it's much more static. There's way less movement and it feels a lot calmer. When we look at both side by side, the difference is pretty clear. With Motion High, we get camera push-ins, tracking shots, all that dynamic stuff. With Motion Low, the shots are more stable, more grounded. And that can actually be really useful depending on the mood or type of scene you're going for. Motion Low is great when you need calm, static shots, especially for storytelling moments where you don't want the camera to distract from what's happening. Motion High, on the other hand, is perfect for action scenes or sequences where you really want to bring the animation to life. Once you've generated your video, you'll see some extra options appear at the bottom right of the screen. If you're selecting an image, those options let you animate it. But if you click on a video you've already generated, those same buttons let you extend the animation. So for example, I'll take one of my videos here, click on it, and you'll see down at the bottom the options have changed, now therefore extending the video, either with low motion or high motion. So just like before, you can choose between a more stable extension or a more dynamic one, depending on the feel you're going for. Alright, so now here are a few shots again. You can see the movements are much smoother and the camera work is a lot more interesting. So how do I get this kind of result? Earlier, I used the automatic mode to generate the videos, but there's also a manual mode. And with this one, I enter my own prompt. That gives me more control over what the model creates. Just like before, I have two options, low motion and high motion. But now, when I click, for example, on high motion, I see a text bar appear just below. That's where I type my own prompt. Here's the exact prompt I use. Fighting with powerful attacks, powerful impact, devastation, anime style. I use words like powerful impact and devastation to get more dynamic scenes, better action, and stronger visual effects. And of course, I can always refine the prompt further, add camera movement, specific actions, or anything I want to shape the animation exactly how I imagine it. But with this little prompt, you'll see that you can already get some interesting results. When you switch to manual mode, you get access to this little button right here. By clicking on it, you open up a menu with different settings. Here, you can choose the motion, either high or low. It's the same thing as before. Right below that, you also have the option to choose between fast mode and relax mode. Now, relax mode is only available if you're on a plan higher than the pro plan. It lets you generate an unlimited number of videos, but as the name suggests, it takes more time. Fast mode, on the other hand, creates your videos more quickly, but it uses up your GPU time. Then finally, you can also enable stealth mode. This lets you generate your videos privately, so they won't be visible to others in the community feed. Just like relax mode, stealth mode is only available if you're on the pro plan or above. We'll talk more about these plan differences in just a bit.
There we go. The animation is done loading. As you can see, we now get much clearer motion. Honestly, the movements look a lot more convincing, way more fluid compared to what we got using the automatic mode. It just feels more polished, more intentional. So here's the thing. When you generate a video using automatic mode, it simply reuses the prompt that was used to create the image. And that prompt isn't always suited for animation, especially if you want dynamic action or camera movement. That's why the results might look kind of flat or not super interesting. But when you switch to manual mode and write your own prompt, something tailored to motion, you immediately get better, more expressive results.
I really encourage you to experiment and come up with your own prompts too. Writing prompts specifically for video generation is actually a whole skill on its own. Honestly, it deserves a full tutorial by itself. We won't go into all of that today, but it's definitely something we'll explore in a future video.
Now, just so you know, you're not limited to using images from Midjourney. You can absolutely use your own images too.
So here's how it works. I go into my folder, pick an image I want to use, and simply drag and drop it right here into the first section. And that's it. The image is uploaded directly into Midjourney. You'll see it appear right here in the interface. Now I can enter my own prompt. In this case, I'll go with something like close-up view on the monster fighting, powerful attacks, powerful impacts, devastation, anime style. And just like before, I have access to the same settings. I can choose the motion type, high or low, pick between fast or relaxed mode, and even enable stealth mode if I want the animation to stay private.
Alright, so the videos have now been generated. As you can see, our images have been transformed into animations.
Now let's talk a bit about the model itself. Can we say this model is revolutionary? At the very least, it certainly represents a significant step forward in AI-generated anime. When you look at existing models in this space, some of the most notable ones include Vidu and Ray 2, both of which have produced impressive results. There are also other models like Kling and so on. Personally, the ones I've used the most so far have been Vidu and Ray 2. What really sets this new model apart is its ability to handle something that has been particularly challenging until now, motion. Creating believable, natural-looking movement has been really difficult, but with this model, we get smooth, coherent motion, both dynamic and high quality. Up until now, if you wanted dynamic animation and natural movement, it usually came with a lot of trial and error. And often, the results still lacked consistency. For example, I tried to create a hand animation using Rail 2. I generated countless videos just to get the hand movement nearly right, and still, it often looked unnatural. But with this new model, if I want to animate hands playing the piano, for example, I can now get natural movement much more easily. This model has a strong capacity for animating characters in a way that feels lifelike and fluid.
But that's not all. It also has a really strong understanding of prompts, as well as excellent camera movements, really solid camera direction. For example, in one of my animations, there was a scene where the boy was sitting and I wanted the camera to zoom in and show his notebook with some drawings in it. And the model didn't just understand the camera movement, it executed it exactly how I had imagined. The hand movements were great, the way the pages turned was spot on, and it really captured every detail I had in mind. Even the drawings, those were very specific and the model managed to generate exactly what I was looking for. Overall, the model is just really strong across the board, especially when it comes to animation. In terms of motion, honestly, in the past, whenever I had to animate a specific action or scene, I'd always be a bit apprehensive. If a character had to walk or do anything like that, I used to rely on tricks just to avoid the animation part.
So, does that mean this is the best model and that you should only use this one?
That's a common question. People often ask, which model is the best? But honestly, that question is a bit of a trap, because most of the time, different models complement each other. Now, it's true that this one is among the best, if not the best, in terms of value for quality, but I really encourage you to try out different models, because each one has its strengths and specific use cases. Take Vidu, for example. What's interesting about Vidu is its 2D rendering. It offers a very unique visual style with strong consistency, both in terms of character appearance and overall visual design, and it's really fluid. That's especially true for Vidu Q1. Now, because Vidu leans more toward a 2D aesthetic, fake, it tends to struggle a bit when it comes to depth. On the other hand, models that produce more of a 3D look usually handle depth much better. That's why I recommend trying out multiple models. Each one brings something different to the table, and depending on your project, one might suit your needs better than another. Now, when it comes to the downsides, one of the main issues is the moderation system, which is currently way too sensitive. I've had a lot of generations fail simply because the moderation flags content that really doesn't need to be censored. There's nothing inappropriate in the image or prompt, but it still gets blocked, and that can be really frustrating. Another issue is the presence of certain common artifacts. These are fairly generic visual glitches, things you'd expect from earlier versions of models like Vidu, which have since been patched. But in Midjourney's video model, you still see these issues pop up. For example, if you have a character in a close-up shot, it might automatically start talking, even if you didn't ask for that. Another example is when a character is wearing a mask. Sometimes the model will animate them speaking through the mask, as if it weren't there. These are older, well-known bugs that have been fixed in more recent models, but unfortunately, they're still present in this one. Now you might be thinking, this model must be pretty expensive, right? But actually, no. It's one of the most affordable models out there, if not the cheapest on the market. The price-to-quality ratio is genuinely excellent. For example, when it comes to video generation in relax mode, on other platforms that can take quite a long time. But with Midjourney, you can generate 4 videos in relax mode in just 3 to 5 minutes. That's about 1 video per minute, which is very fast. In fact, it's even faster than what some platforms offer in their so-called fast mode. As for the pricing, at around 30 euros, you get over 400 fast mode video generations. Once again, this places it among the most cost-effective options currently available. So yes, it's definitely a very appealing offer. Alright, now as usual, I'm going to combine the different clips I generated using a video editing software. Like here, for example, with CapCut. Then I'll add music and sound effects either from CapCut's built-in library or by downloading SFX from the internet. I'll also add some visual effects and voiceovers. For the voices, I'm using 11 Labs. They recently released an update and the quality of the voices is on a whole new level. In fact, the voice you're hearing right now is generated with 11 Labs. I'm not using my own voice because I prefer to stay anonymous. Alright, let's take a look at the kind of results you can get. Let's go.
だが今、新たな存在が現れた。映像を理解し、動きを予測し、魂を持たぬまま魂を描く。そして、俺の言葉はもう終わった。痛みも、もう聞こえない。俺のは、ただ一つ。進め、という声だけだ。価値は語る。そして、俺の言葉はもう終わった。
And that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video. You can really feel that we've reached a new milestone in AI-generated anime, and that's super exciting. That said, there's still a long road ahead, and it's a journey we'll be making over the next few years. The next tutorial will show you how to create a fan-made anime, specifically a Demon Slayer fan project. That video will be released on July 8th. My top priority though is to release a beginner-friendly tutorial, something designed for people who've never made AI anime before. I also want to make videos focused on adding voice and sound effects, because honestly, that's a crucial part of the process. Now about the website I've been developing for the past few months. It'll include tons of prompt packs for images and videos, as well as full course modules. I'll share more details when it launches, which should be in less than a month. It's been a lot of work, and that's part of why I haven't been super active lately. As for the second episode of Kuro Nyuki, I had actually created a 10-minute animation, which took me hundreds of hours to complete. It was honestly one of the biggest projects I've ever worked on, but in the end, I wasn't happy with the result, so I didn't publish it. Instead, I plan to make a video showing some behind-the-scenes clips and do a making-of, which I think will be really insightful for you. I'm currently reworking episode 2, and I'm actually thinking of starting the series before the events of episode 1. That way, you'll get to know who Kuro and Yuki are, what this institute is all about, and really get a better feel for the universe as a whole. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed this video. Normally, when I review a new model, I just do a quick 2-minute video with no voiceover.
but since so many of you asked for a more in-depth review, I finally found the motivation to make one. Thank you so much for your support. If you have any questions or suggestions for future tutorials, feel free to share them. And as always, best of luck with your own projects.